You asked, is there? What's the accent? Bonjour, bonjour, fragrance lovers. This is Clémence. I'm talking about fragrance and welcome back. In today's video, it's a women's video and you've been asking it because in the previous video, we've seen a top of best perfume of all time and we were all shocked.
That's a big joke. It is not acceptable.
They say best perfume of all time. These are not my personal favorite and these are not the most popular, I would say, all the time. Well, they are super popular, but you know. It's the perfume that I think are timeless. So that will last ages, then we still gonna love in 10,000 years that people used to love in the 20s, but now still love it. You know, like things like this. One of the lists, you were expecting it. I didn't see on the list last time and I was shocked. I'm like, you put a list of best perfume of all time and you're not including number 5. For me, the most timeless fragrance in the world, it's a floral aldehyde. So aldehyde, why? Because it's fizzy, it smells like champagne. Kind of oriental as well, with this vanilla, vetiver that is here. It's just something that you smell, and for me it doesn't have any age. And if you think that number 5 smell too mature, you didn't know the full range. You've got now number 5 Low, that is a very fresh and modern version of number 5, and I think it's absolutely stunning and modern. So you can just take the DNA of number 5 and create something extraordinary. You've got the Eau de Toilette that is more woody. You've got the Eau de Parfum more vanilla-like. You've got the Pure Parfum that is more creamy, flower-like, like a nectar. The L'Eau that is more citrusy. So a number 5 for everyone. And for me, an absolute must-have. Did you actually know that in France during the Second World War, it was the only perfume allowed to be sold? Like, it was only this one, number 5 in France.
Hey, that's Clémence of the future. I just watched my top and I was like, listen, I need to add Rolling in Love from Kilian. I think it would be timeless in a few years. It's just something that is really sensual, creamy, milky note, extremely addictive, and I think it deserves its place here.
So I try to not doubling up. For example, I'm not going to speak about Two Guerlain or Two Chanel. I know the Two House got very big timeless fragrance, but I have to choose this most iconic fragrance house in the world and in France. And the one that I think is the most iconic is Shalimar. It's still kind of being like in those floral aldehydic, you know, because it's quite fizzy as well, but it's more in-depth, oriental, that slight smoke and this really charm. It smells super sensual, mysterious and charming. Princess, an Arabian princess to me. And again, you've got a Shalimar for everyone. Like, I've got a big crush on the classic that is quite powerful, you know, and it's got a bit more that creamy scent, very vintage as well, that you can find. But the Souffle de Parfum, this powderiness, this silk, it's a silk veil of an oriental trail. It's absolutely stunning, so I love, love that. But Shalimar in general, have to be there. Lac Orchid by Tom Ford. So if we have to pick like a most timeless fragrance, you have to get Lac Orchid. I mean, it's some kind of a fragrance that will divide people. Or you hate it or you love Lac Orchid, but most of the people really enjoy it, and it's the staple in a ladies collection, and I think it's gonna stay forever. Like, Lac Orchid is there since long. There's a new version now that I really like, actually, the new version. It's a bit more boozy, slightly more masculine actually to me, and the classic, the Black Bottle, is more feminine. For a lady that is not scared to have something daring, dramatic. Like, it makes me think of the Eva Green of a fragrance. Yeah, she's drama. She's drama, but discreet. You know what I mean?
Thank God it's sunny today. Look at this guy. Amazing. Bronze Goddess by Estée Lauder. So I love this fragrance because it's basically coconut and tiare flower. And tiare flower just smell like, you know, the sun on your face. One of the most iconic coconut vanilla fragrance, and one of the most iconic suntan lotion fragrance, I would say. It's one of my iconic fragrance for any summertime. It's timeless as well, and it's got slightly a vintage tone as well, so I think that's really pretty actually. So yeah,
Christian, and it's number one. I do honestly think that Clef Christian is really expensive. If you don't know, it used to be the fragrance of the queen, very intense floral fragrance. You've got like this vibe as number five, but I would say it's more floral and slightly more delicate, but it's got very like ultimate femininity. Smell ultra natural. It's nearly like you take a bouquet of flower from the grass and smell it, and it smells very nectar as well, nearly oily. So it's really an essence of flowers. So it's very beautiful, it's very romantic and extremely classy. Ciso Rodriguez Poudre. For me, a house that is really standing out in the designer range. So I could choose for her, that I think for me would also stay. But my favorite is Narciso Poudre, and that's really my taste that is talking now. Ah, I cut myself with the paper. Ouch. This is sexy and sensual. It's so powdery, but really, really intense, like it's pulsing. And I love that in there. It's like not too floral as well. It's a bit like in between. It's something that is not the usual femininity that you usually get. Like, it's not like this overly sweet fragrance that designer likes to use. It's not fruity. It's more like this powder, like a lot of powder. It's nearly this blush effect, you know, like when you apply your makeup or stuff like that. That's really that, but pulsing to the max. Super long lasting, super longevity, and for me, like something that is incredible. And you're gonna be surprised, but my next one is...
I realized I could have definitely had Portrait of a Lady from Frédéric Malle, who had that darkness, spicy, dark rose.
Carnal Flower, Frédéric Malle. A very nectar, again, flower. So tuberose, and tuberose is the most fragrant flower in the world. It's super, super creamy. For a lady that wants to still be elegant, but want to have something sexy without going to the sweet or the gourmand, really blended to perfection to me again, beautifully done. But what I like is that kind of essence vibe. It's oily. Next one is a cute little one, and that's one of my favorite designer ever since years. It's got nothing special, but I do really love it, and it's Chloe. I never talked about it, I think, in my channel, but it's something that is my guilty pleasure. I just think that it's so delicate. A little lily of the valley, romantic, like it's super, super romantic, delicate, charming, but like really a bit shy, you know, that's what it makes me think of. Really classy, but like more in a shy way, like you want to be cute, you know. It's a strong value, like if you want like a delicate, cute scent, there you go. Hesitated for that. It's from Byredo, but I hesitated between Moyev Ghost and Bal d'Afrique. But I think the most iconic one, and the one that is going to be like more timeless, is going to be definitely Bal d'Afrique. Has that fruity note, but also some kind of like a greenness and woodiness to it, with an ambery trail that is not too gourmand, it's not too prominent. Fizziness, it's fresh, but also some character, and it's something that is really, really different. And I think on women that want to have a fresh scent for summer, but even for men to be fair, it's really pretty. And that very blackcurrant, I think, note is incredible. So I highly recommend for you to try Bal d'Afrique. You won't regret it. On timeless fragrance, and okay, that was difficult to say, but I'm telling you, this is not my proper list. Like, this is something that I think is gonna stay, you know, like some fragrance that I think are gonna stay forever. I included Baccarat Rouge 540. I would prefer if that was my top to be like, yeah, put Grand Soir. It was kind of a revolution for us. There's not a lot of like fragrances that does that revolution, you know. It's overly caramel-like sweetness, fluffiness, and smelling super expensive with that all this sugar and gourmand vibe, but not really gourmand to me. For me, Baccarat is more sugar. Super luxurious on women. That's why it smells luxury to me, like posh babe. It's not something I will wear myself that much, but I enjoy it as well. Before, we didn't have that kind of smell. And also, now men are wearing as much as ladies baccarat rouge. So I think because he did that, it's going to stay forever. And then my last one, not one of my favorite fragrance, but it was actually one of my first fragrance. And it's Angel by Thierry Mugler. So a fragrance that really divide people. This chocolatey note is very different, and it's got very recognizable scent. Kind of the kind of fragrance that really intoxicates everyone. Not something I would wear all the time, but I really enjoy it. Thierry Mugler does fragrance that are very strange, like very different. And it smells the 80s to me, 80s, 90s to me, like this, well, exactly like this, like it's nearly like you're wearing that kind of top, you know, it's extravagant and it's different and unique. And when it was launched, I think it was 1992, no, because it was my date of birth. I'm not sure, I need to check that, but I think it was. It was a massive revolution. Angel, like, I mean, like, everyone was wearing that, so I think that's why people are like, ah, enough is enough. But you know, like, now you've got customers that I remember when I was working in perfumery store that are religiously attached to this fragrance, like, it's a religion. So you can't reproduce that smell, absolutely not. And it was also the first one to have this fountain, you know, so I mean, incredible. So yeah, that's my list, guys. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope you like to spend a little time with me on timeless fragrance. This is something that I'm gonna do for men as well, but yeah, remember, it's not my usual top. It's things that I think are gonna stay really long. But yeah, I wish you a lovely day. Thank you for everyone that is following me, liking. If you like the video, little button, it's free. And I want to say a special thank you to my uTip community that are tipping me every month to give me a little contribution. It's really much appreciated. You're not obviously forced to do that, but you still do it for me. And this is really helping me, like, to put some money aside to get some new material. So thank you. I love you to the moon and back. And I will see you very soon. Bye now.